you will hear. This could be the first trumpet, might as well be the last. Many more will have to suffer. Many more will have to die. Of course, I'm paraphrasing. And of course, you know, Oliver ended it by, don't ask me why. But I am here to deliver a word, but I'm here on a spiritual journey at the same time. Because something has happened at Motor Sales that I'm going to have to quickly address before I get right to the lecture, which is good because it's just bringing everything together in the way that I hope and pray God wants it to be. The last time I was invited to speak, I was by Gillian Rowland, who I love very, very, very much, and I want to thank you for caring for the country and for our people. I was supposed to speak on deals on wheels, and I went to laughing, and I went totally off. I just felt a spirit, and some of you have seen it. Now it's going to circulate, but I felt, I guess we'd say in Jamaica, a vibe. I don't want to be too religious. So I felt a vibe to deal with the youth. You know, of course, it was careers, and the youth were out in numbers. And I just wanted to speak to both the youth and the students as to why, as a country, we're in the condition that we're in. I mentioned certain things about emancipation not being independence. Emancipation comes from two Latin words called mancipere, which means to free from one's hand but not from one's control. And that's why we have a governor general. And I spoke recently somewhere else, and I had to remind the audience that, you know, the struggle is not over. And unfortunately, you know, this generation don't even know that there is a struggle. They don't realize that the onward march for independence and true freedom has not arrived. And so what is happening is the masses of our people are miseducated, undereducated, and are suffering. As the scripture says, our people are perishing for the lack of knowledge. And our leaders, religious politicians and others, business people, have become, I wish Jesus could come again and throw out the money changers, because the business people have not stepped up to the plate yet either, the private sector that is, and our religious leaders are somewhere, some of them, above, beyond the rainbow. So, I would like to start by saying that I have a problem with Jamaica, in Jamaica. I have a problem with education. Education in Jamaica that is based on white supremacy. I have a problem with that. I have a problem that we, as a nation and as a people and as leaders, have not seen fit to re-educate or to change the curriculum in Jamaica to inspire the youth of Jamaica. I'm on a school tour presently, and every school that I go to, I have to address bleaching. And when you do, you can see the ooh and the ah over the people. Well, why wouldn't they bleach? What image is being portrayed to them as beauty? What is the image that is being portrayed in religion? Who is in the Bible? So I have a problem with education. And I've asked in the last talk that I had at the Pegasus, and I'm going to ask today at the Terranova, that the Minister of Education, Andrew Holness, a young bright spark, you need to change the curriculum in Jamaica. Go overseas and see what is going on overseas. Look at the private schools that teach self. You have a country that is over 95% black. You have a certain percentage of Chinese and Indians. And we say out of many, one people. And I like that. But I say out of many, one people have all the money. And if we all don't have the same access to education, then we have a problem. And let me tell you, let me say something to the one people who have the money. You won't be able to have that money much longer. It's a matter of time. I've been seeing it in the news recently. And I'm just the weatherman. I'm here to sound the alarm. There will come a time that they will come up to our neighborhoods. It's right there. So if you think that this country is going to continue this way while people are hungry and suffering and starving. You know, we like corporate citizens, good corporates. We're talking, we want to help and we talk these nice words. And this is good. But I'm here to sound the alarm. I'm here to be the trumpet, the final call. Because if you don't know what is going on within the ghettos, I am here to tell you it's not nice. I have been to Tivoli. The motor sales is at the entrance or the back of motor sales is Almontown. I speak to all the dons. I know people that I certainly would not see. And when I talk to these people and listen, one of the things I heard from one of our young brothers who would like to call a ghetto youth, him said, boy, you know, sometimes, him said, no, he just said sometimes, he says, the vibe that we have in the ghetto. Well, I have a problem with education. I have a problem with the economics of this country. The economics of this country has changed from Sir Alexander Bustamante, Sir Washington Norman Manley, of independence, industrialization, all of these wonderful things that any independent person, you leave your mother's home, you need to go get a job. You need to be independent. To investment. What is investment? Investment is the talk that politicians use 80% of the time now. We are going to work on investment. What is investment? Oh, it means that you're going to give the land, your resource to another to develop it so that they can create jobs. Nothing really, really wrong with that, because you have to be wise in this world. But how could that be your vision? How could your vision be to rent your property and sell your property to foreigners? And that's your vision for the entire nation? Importation is your vision? I grew up in Portmore. And having gone overseas and coming back home, and going over the Causeway Bridge, and seeing what I see as the wharf, the containers have quadrupled. It has absolutely just gone. What does that mean? It means that nobody is working now in Jamaica. So I have a problem with the economics of this country. The few industrial businesses that we have in the country, we have over 50%, I believe it's more, tax evasion in this country. The tax that is being evaded not by the poor, the tax that's being evaded by the rich of the country. And if you want money, go and get the money from the private sectors of Jamaica. You can drop the GCT tax from 8% to 4% for the hotels. But you can't drop the taxes of GCT and gasoline. As a matter of fact, you want to increase it. And let me tell you right now, I'm completely bipartisan. You will see that in a second. I have a problem with the fashion that especially our young women, our young sisters are wearing. That is based on the people from Paris. I have a problem with it. If you don't know, you're not necessarily, my sisters, shaped like they are.